My name is Shane Handy. I'm the founder of therationaltrader.com. This is a somewhat unique trading education service that's designed to teach you to trade in a very controlled, very methodical way. Lucky, thank you for joining me today. We're going to talk about the three challenges all traders face, and those challenges are based on a core understanding of human nature, which I call market biology. I will define that for you shortly. I'd like to say a quick thank you to Reed and Investor Inspiration for hosting us today. Thank you, Reed. We don't have a lot of time, so I'm not going to spend a lot of time on my background, but what I will say right at the outset here is that I'm a trader. I run a live trading room. I trade with real money live in front of people every day. I have a very clear understanding of what it takes to be a trader and what it takes to learn how to trade. Now, the nature of today's presentation is such that you should just hold questions until we get to the end. We have cleared the audio tests. So let's start with this observation. There is an often cited statistic that 95% of all new traders lose all their money within a year. 95%. Now, I haven't seen the data, so I can't independently verify it, but my own personal experience bears this out, as does every conversation I've had on this topic with every broker I know. 95% of all new traders lose all their money within a year. So think on this next statement during our discussion today. If everyone is failing at something and you want to succeed, you have to do something different than what everyone else is doing. If you want to succeed where everyone else is failing, you have to do something different than what they're doing, because what they're doing isn't working. The question is, why is the failure rate so high? I'm going to share with you what I believe is the answer. We're going to talk about the root cause of that failure and what you can do about it. Moving from the general framework for success you need to have in place down to specifics, including what elements need to be present in your trade setups. Now, before we continue, there are four aspects to any discussion of trading that you need to be aware of. I suspect you have seen this information before, but I would request that you don't tune out. I have a very specific take on these items that relates to our discussion today. The first is risk. Trading is risky. You can lose all your money. You can even lose more than your initial investment if you're dealing with leverage. And in fact, we just talked about that statistic. One of my goals at therationaltrader.com is to teach you how to trade, or to help you to learn how to trade without losing all of your money in the process. Next is suitability. Trading is not for everyone. My take on this is that a trader experiences on a daily basis a level of emotional intensity that is simply not part of your average person's daily routine. And it's not for everyone, and you may find that it doesn't suit you. And the sooner you know this, the better. Third is performance. Past performance is not indicative of future results. This statement is almost a cliche, but it's true. It's just not true for the reason you think it is. And we're going to talk about this today in detail, but I'll tell you now, two people can be following the same trading methodology, executing the same trading system, and one will be profitable and the other will not. There's clearly something more at work than just the trading system. Fourth is hypothetical or simulated results are not to be trusted, especially if they're given to you by someone that's selling you a trading system. Simulated results are often produced with the benefit of hindsight. And I promise you, if you give me any data set, I can craft a profitable trading system from it because I already know what happened. More importantly, there's no risk in a simulation or a back test. And risk is the most important factor in trading. It's more important than anything else. Risk is the reason one person makes money while the other doesn't, even though they're both executing the same trading system, because they each handle risk differently. So a simulated result is not very useful, since it's missing the most important element. Now, I will take this one step further and tell you, don't even trust actual results. The financial markets are littered with the corpses of traders who had a great track record until the day they didn't, because they didn't understand the risks they were taking and did not have appropriate measures in place to protect themselves. It doesn't do you any good to turn a profit if you can't keep it. The stories are legion. You never hear about the small traders who blow up their accounts, but you hear about the big ones. My favorite is the emerging market bond trader who made $40 or $50 million for his bank over the course of a few years and then lost $600 million in a week because he didn't understand the risks he was taking and he didn't protect himself. Any methodology you employ to trade the markets must include solid measures to protect your account for the times when the market does not do what you expect, including protecting your account from yourself. And with that statement, we segue into why nearly everyone loses. One way to approach this question is to look at what everyone else is doing and don't do that. Another way is to look at what they aren't doing but should be doing. Now, when people, it turns out here that it's this latter case that is where we find our answer. When people start trading, they begin by learning technical analysis of the markets, bar charts, tick charts, moving averages, oscillators, stochastics, etc., etc., etc. And this is important stuff. There is a basic foundation of knowledge that you need in order to understand what the market is doing. But notice that I said what the market is doing, not why the market is doing it. The why is much more important. This is the first challenge you face as a trader, figuring out what technical method you're going to use. And here is where everyone runs into trouble, because everyone focuses exclusively on learning technical analysis, thinking that this is the primary skill needed to be a successful trader. And it's no surprise they think this, because there are hundreds of indicators out there and an endless way to combine them and use them. And everyone is talking about all the different ways to analyze the markets. So to a newcomer, it looks like this is where you need to focus your attention. It's perfectly understandable. But this is where everyone falls down. The beginning of understanding why nearly everyone loses money is this. Technical analysis. Analysis of the markets is an intellectual activity, but trading is not. Trading is not an intellectual activity. Analysis is. Technical analysis, it's a logical thought process. It uses the puzzle-solving part of your brain, the cognitive functions, the frontal lobes. It's an intellectual activity, but trading, actually placing a trade with real money on the line, real money, your money, at risk of being lost, is not an intellectual activity. A different part of your psyche is involved, and it's a part that hasn't been developed by your efforts at learning technical analysis. You can be an expert analyst, but still be an infant trader. Technical analysis, it's a mandatory skill, but it's not the only skill you need to be successful as a trader. And when you develop your technical analysis skills, you are not developing the skill you need to actually trade with. Remember, everyone is talking about the technical analysis of the markets, but everyone is failing. So, if trading is not analytical or logical, then what is it? When you have something of value at risk, your body reacts the way nature intended it to. And it doesn't matter what's at risk, only that you care about it. The more you care about it, the greater the reaction you'll experience. If someone or something tries to harm you, your body automatically, autonomously reacts. And we call this the fight or flight syndrome. If there's a threat to your child, say your toddler steps out onto a busy street, your body reacts and you leap into action to save your child. And I'm speaking as a father of three-year-old twins. Those two are like herding cats. This response is physical. It's a physiological response that's in your biology. It's not intellectual. It's not rational. It's glandular, in fact. It's autonomous also. You have no control over it. And in fact, you don't want to control it. It is an important part of your survival mechanism as a human being, but it's working against you as a trader. And I'll clarify why in a moment. Your body does not make a distinction between a threat to your life, a threat to your child, or a threat to your livelihood, or your reputation, or your ego. It doesn't understand there's a difference. It reacts the same way regardless of the type of danger you're in. So when you have something of value at stake, your body responds. And the greater the value you place on it, the more intense the response. So when you place a trade, you have money at risk. You value that money, and your biology responds. This is a perfectly natural reaction. But it doesn't stop there, because you have much more than just money at stake, much more. Now, we have to talk for a moment about why you're trading. Most people are trading because they want to secure a better future for themselves and their loved ones. When you strip away everything else, this is what you find. You want to provide for your retirement. You want to provide for your child's college education. Or you don't want to have to worry about being able to provide for them because of the economy or your industry or the decisions our political leaders are making. You could say you want freedom from worry. Or, even deeper, control over your own destiny. So beyond the money that's at risk, this is what's at stake. And this is what your biology reacts to when you place a trade. All the hopes and dreams you have about being successful in the markets are now tied to this trade. All the fear, anxiety, doubt, excitement, greed, euphoria, all of it is amplified and concentrated down into this one moment in time. And this happens all day, every day when you're trading. You can see the fear in the market almost every day as traders bail out of positions that are killing their accounts, and the excitement as traders chase a market up or down. Both behaviors are in reaction to a biological response, and both are losing propositions. And now we've arrived at why nearly everyone loses money. The vast majority of traders make decisions rooted in their biology, in their basic human nature. They're acting either in response to excitement or as a means to alleviate their fear or anxiety. And the markets have evolved to take advantage of this. They've evolved to take advantage of human nature. This is the reason nearly everyone loses money. There is a Darwinian process underway. It's been going on for many, many years, and by this point in time, it's honed to a razor's edge. This is what you're jumping into, and if you don't understand what's really going on, if you don't understand the market dynamics underlying why prices move, then you're going to fail. This makes perfect sense when you think about it, because trading is a zero-sum game. There is a winner and a loser, and you are in competition with every other trader out there. Everyone is trying to take money from everyone else. The money that you make is not created out of thin air. It comes from someone else's account. So for you to make money, someone else has to lose money. Now it's more useful to examine that statement from the other direction. For someone else to make money, you have to lose money. It's competition in its purest form. Now, you obviously don't want to give your hard-earned cash to some other trader. So they have to trick you into doing the wrong thing. Or stated another way, the market has evolved ways to tempt you into doing something foolish, and it does so by preying on your natural biological reactions to having something of value at stake. In order to be successful as a trader, when you are most afraid to do something is when you most need to do it. And when you are the most excited is when you most need to be cautious. Think of your account like a baby that you're holding in your hands. Protect it. Care for it. Don't drop it. If you want to be successful as a trader, you have to make dispassionate decisions that are based on data. The vast majority of traders make biology-based decisions in response to fear or excitement. You want to be on the other side of these traders. They're the ones making emotional decisions. They're the ones succumbing to the siren call of the market, providing you with the opportunity to profit. Think about it for a moment. Who's on the other side of your trade? Who is taking the other side? Every trade has a buyer and a seller. Who's on the other side? Is it a newbie chasing the market or a professional trader who's been patiently waiting for this trade setup all day long? And who do you want that person to be? That person is actually very important to your success. For that matter, who do you want to be? The predator or the prey? Because that's the relationship you're in, whether you like it or not. And you're either one or the other. People that are new to trading spend all of their time and energy navigating through the maze of countless technical analysis methods and no time at all on mastering their biology. As a result, they're unable to effectively implement the technical method because a different set of skills is required to actually trade in the face of your natural biological reactions to the market action. This is why your actual results don't meet the expectations from your analysis, and it's why nearly everyone loses. This is the second challenge you face as a trader, mastering your biology. It's much harder than the technical challenge. The question is, how do you master it? Even better, how do you get the biology working for you instead of against you? Now, one of the things you've probably heard is that you need to be more disciplined, or you need to follow your plan. Now, this is basically useless advice. It's useless because you already know it. Of course you need to be disciplined. Of course you need to follow your plan. But you're not a computer program. You can't just change a few lines of code and recompile. You cannot decide at an intellectual level that you want to behave differently and then expect your body to follow suit. It doesn't work that way. Think of someone who's struggling to lose weight, like me. Telling me to eat less and exercise more is useless. That's irritating for me that, since I already know it. Much better for me to structure my life so I would eat less and exercise more. Through a combination of risk management, trading plans, live trading, we show you how to structure your trading so that you can develop biology. The discipline is what's needed to be a successful trader. I'm going to spend the next few minutes talking about how to do this. How do you go about mastering your biology? System, there's no other way. There's no shortcut. I'll give you two examples from other walks of life and then show you how this applies. The armed forces and the martial arts are two examples. A soldier must be trained to perform under the stress of battle. In the army, they do through endless repetition, drill after drill after basic training, you'll come out the other side, able to field strip a rifle, bicycle through a rock. Now the martial arts are similar. I have a Japanese style of karate called Shoryu. I was an instructor for many years at the Army. Many of the concepts I've implemented at the martial arts. And what we do when we're teaching the martial arts, I'll show you what to do technically, how to make a fist, where to meet the attack, or step out of range, etc. All the details. And then we have someone try and hit you many, many times. Now the first times, at first, you're basically terrified because your body is responding the way nature intended, but through repetition, the fear recedes, and after blocking the 100th punch, it's routine. And by 500, it's downright boring. Now it's the same with trading. By the 100th trade, it's routine. And by the 500th, it's so automatic, you don't even think about it. It's like tying your shoes. You just do it. The challenge for you as a new trader is to get to the 100th trade with your account intact. Get to 500 trades with your account intact. and you're well and truly on your way. Now, I'm going to tell you a story, a true story, that illustrates this need for two skills, a technical skill and a skill that the skill of mastering your biology. In the martial arts, in the Japanese martial arts, we do something called kata, which translates to form. And it's a series of movements that you perform, and you use it to practice your technique and ultimately to demonstrate your mastery of that technique. And they range from beginner to very advanced. There's probably 50 or 60 in my particular style. There are people, well, there's one thing that's important to understand. You do this by yourself, like this gentleman you see on screen. You're practicing the technique by yourself. No one's attacking you while you're doing it. It's a way to hone your technique. There are people who are absolute masters of the technique. You watch them perform. You watch them execute the kata, and it's awe-inspiring. They move with such poise and grace, precision, speed, and power. It's truly, truly amazing. But they can't beat me in a fight. You take that same person, and you put on gloves, and you get in the ring, and they lose almost every time. And sometimes it's not even a contest. Now, not everybody. But there's a large category, a large number of people in this category that are technically excellent, but can't fight. Training, it's the same. There are a lot of people who are technically excellent, but they can't train. The reason is they focused exclusively on the technical skill. In training, it's technical analysis. In the martial arts, there's a physical technique. The epiphany that I had after the requisite years of pain and suffering at the hands of the market is that this skill of mastering your biology that you need in the martial arts is identical in trading. You need that same skill. And so once I understood that, I knew how to structure it because I teach this, all right, as a martial artist. So our goal is to get you to your 100th trade with your account intact. So if you're taking, say, 2 trades per day, that's 10 trades a week. We're talking about roughly 10 weeks. This is your first checkpoint. Get 100 trades under your belt while keeping your account intact, and then stop and evaluate how you're doing. What we're doing is, in a very controlled way, allowing you to experience enough trades and market action to beat the fear, anxiety, doubt, excitement, greed, and euphoria out of your system. You're retraining the biological system that is your body. You need to experience the fear, anxiety, and doubt that comes when a trade sets up and you need to enter the market. You also need to experience the anger when the market stops you out and the frustration when the market takes off without you. Or worse, and this is the one I hate the most, when the market just barely stops you out before turning and moving in the direction of your trade. In other words, there are times when you need to act to enter the market and times when you need to wait for a trade to set up. Both scenarios generate a biological response that you must experience and process. Your job is to still do the right thing no matter what you're feeling. It's very hard to do, though it does get easier. Over time, you learn at a deep level that there's nothing to fear here. There's no danger here. And that physiological response, that biological response, it lessens to a point where it no longer affects you. Now, intellectually, you can put it into perspective. When you realize that this trade is just one trade, it's one trade out of 500 you're going to take this year. That's 1/5 of 1% of the trades you're going to take this year. It may be profitable, it may not. It does not matter. We only enter the market when we believe the probability has shifted in our favor, so we know it will work out for us in the long run. The key is to build the trust in yourself that you're going to follow your rules, that you're going to protect your capital. In order to set yourself up to succeed, you need to structure your trading so that you can build that trust in yourself. To do this, you need three things. The first is an environment where you can experience what you need to safely. The second is an understanding of what you need to do technically. And the third is a guide or a mentor or a teacher to show you the way and help you stay on the path. Now, at therationaltrader.com, we've created a program that implements these elements. The guide is the live trading room. The technical understanding is the trading plan, which is executed in the live trading room. And the safe environment is the set of rules that define your risk and how you'll protect yourself. Let's talk for a moment about setting up a safe environment to trade in, because for learning to trade, it's the most difficult element to deal with. In the armed forces, they will teach you everything you could possibly know about that rifle, but they don't give you live ammunition while they're doing it. In the martial arts, we employ gloves and pads to avoid injury. In trading, a safe environment is one where you cannot damage yourself too badly if you make a mistake or lose control of yourself. This equates to taking a small loss rather than a large or catastrophic loss. Now, it's a lot more challenging to set up a safe environment for trading than it is for either the armed forces or the martial arts. And the reason is you must have real money on the line or you're wasting your time. You should trade on a simulator only as long as it takes you to learn the trading software and your trading system. On a simulator, you are not developing the primary skill you need to be successful as a trader, because with nothing at stake, your biology is not engaged. You have to have real money on the line. That means you're trading in live trading conditions. Live conditions means you're trading against professionals. I cannot think of another case that's like this, where you have to learn in a live environment against professionals who are not your friends. It's one of the reasons it's so hard to learn to trade. Imagine learning a martial art with a training partner who's a professional fighter who's trying to knock you out. This is the third challenge you face as a trader. There is no practice environment. You must learn to trade in live conditions. Now, one of the elements of the program at therationaltrader.com is creating a safe environment to trade in. And I do it in what I call the business plan, which is the upper left puzzle piece there. I don't have time to go into those details today. So if you'd like more information about how to create a safe environment to trade in, about how to get to 100 trades with your account intact, then I encourage you to visit the website and click on the business plan puzzle piece. This is the most important thing you need to do if you want to learn how to trade. Create a safe environment to learn in. We're going to talk about trade setups in a minute, but before we do, let's summarize why nearly everyone loses money. The primary reason is because of a fundamental misunderstanding about what skill they need to learn. The secondary reason is the fact that they have to learn in live conditions. People new to trading spend all their time and energy learning technical analysis methods and no time at all on mastering their biology. Technical analysis is a logical thought process, but trading is not. Trading, actually placing a trade with real money on the line, real money, your money, at risk of being lost, it engages a different part of your psyche, and a different set of skills needs to be developed to actually trade in the face of your natural biological reactions to the market. Now, the trade setups that you use need to incorporate this understanding of market biology. This is a key thing here. You are struggling to deal with your own natural biological reactions to having something of value at stake. So is every other market participant. And when we say the market, what we mean is all the traders who are trading that instrument. That's the market. It's a bunch of people, all of whom are subject to the same biology, the same physiological reactions to the market action that we've been discussing. Human motivations drive the market, mostly fear. Your goal as an aspiring trader is to work through the biology-based issues within yourself and recognize those same issues being expressed by the other market participants and then use them to your advantage. When you do this, if you step back and think about it, if you've been struggling to succeed, if you've been failing, what you're doing now is targeting yourself. Let's go back to the sumo slide for a moment. This is a pretty accurate representation of the situation that you're in as an aspiring trader with a small account. And you're not the big guy. You're that little guy. So if you engage in this fight, you're going to lose. It's pretty obvious. Now, a more accurate picture would be about 10 or 20 of these big guys and hundreds of little guys. What you often hear is don't fight the big players. Instead, figure out what they're doing and do the same thing. But that's actually quite difficult to do for a couple of reasons. The first is the bigger players they know you're trying to do that, so they disguise what they're doing because they know you'll front run them. The second reason is they have a larger amount of capital at their disposal, so they can withstand just normal price fluctuations that you with your small account and small stock can't. But there's another approach. Another approach is to find one of the little guys and compete against him. If you can find another one of the little guys, you can even the playing field. This is one of the truly amazing things about trading. You have some control over who you compete against if you can find them. Think about it. If you're a professional tennis player, there's millions of tennis players in the world, but you don't get to pick who you play against. You only get to play against ranked players. This is not the case in trading. To the extent that you can find them, you can choose who to trade against. So when you develop or evaluate a trade setup, you want to know what aspect of human nature is being taken advantage of here. How are the market participants reacting to the action? Is there an edge for you? What's the person on the other side of your trade thinking? This is the key. What is the person on the other side of your trade thinking? You want to find the situations where the person on the other side of your trade is absolutely desperate or foolish. Find the emotion in the market and take the other side. Find the fear and the panic and calmly, rationally, take the other side. This is how you succeed, day after day and week after week. Don't get caught up in the technical aspects of trading. Don't get so caught up in the indicators that you forget that there's another person on the other side of your trade. That person is really important to your success. Now, by way of demonstration, let's go over an example you see every day in the markets. Consider a group of professional traders who are trading moderate to big size. They see the market advancing, and their assessment, right or wrong, is that the market will go higher. So they want to get long, but they can't go long at the market. They just drive the price up. They know that the likely outcome is that the market will pull back. The probable outcome is it'll pull back. So they identify where support is, and they place their orders, or they prepare to buy below support. Now, in the meantime, newer traders chasing the market up out of excitement and fear of missing out have been buying. And what happens next is the traders that got in early start to take profits, and that stalls the price advance. This selling pressure drives the price down. The newer traders that chase the market up out of excitement are now getting stopped out. The smart ones are, the ones that are using stops. This adds further selling pressure, pushing the market lower. What you're seeing here, basic reversion of the mean price behavior. You see it every day in every market. Consider any chart. When you look at that, at the peaks and valleys, at the peak, someone was buying there. Often a lot of someones, and they all lost money. The market breaks support. Well, if the market breaks support, two sets of sell orders execute. The first are the stop orders for people who are long, either protecting gains from earlier, or the people who chase the market up and are underwater and feeling some pain. The second set of orders are new sell orders short for people selling the break of support. This is often newer traders. Newer traders like to enter on breakouts. It's very easy to identify the entry it can move nicely for you and take no heat. Newer traders are forever looking for trades that take no heat because they have trouble dealing with their anxiety and fear if the market moves against their position. That's a very seductive trade, but it's a low probability trade. The odds are against them. Most of the time, they're going to get stopped out on normal price fluctuations as the market thrashes around at support, or on a complete reversal if this turns out to be an ambush zone. And that brings us back to our professional traders. They're still waiting to buy below support. They're like spiders. They've spun a web and are waiting for a fly to come along. So the market breaks support and the two sets of stop orders execute and drive the price down into the professional's orders. These orders get filled, absorbing all the selling, and the market bounces up on all of the buying pressure found below support. And as the market advances, the newer traders that shorted the break are now getting stopped out, and that adds fuel to the advance, and the market just doesn't look back. What you're seeing are the market dynamics of a standard ambush trade, something you see every day in the markets. When I look at this chart, I see two places to enter. The first, at the peak, the market's been moving up strongly. People have gotten excited, or people who are short and did not cover when they should have are getting killed and have to get out. They can't take the pain of their losses anymore. You want to wait until the last exhausted pain rack short is covered, then wait some more for the people who got excited by the market action and chased the move up. Wait for the last of the fear of missing out crowd to buy, and then step in and take the other side. This is a perfectly reasonable place to short, and it would not be unusual for this to be the high of the day. The other entry is at the valley of the pullback, taking advantage of the natural ebb and flow of the markets we've just discussed. Wait for the longs that relate to the party to cover, and then take the other side of the people chasing a low probability break of support. Now, we're going to look at this on a real chart. This is a simplified view of the chart that I use every day to trade with. This is the platform is AT Charts, or Sierra Chart. This is the oil market last Wednesday. It's a 10-tick range bar chart. The vertical lines are different times. This is 6 o'clock in the morning Pacific when the oil market opens, 9 o'clock Eastern. On the right here, 9 o'clock Pacific or noon Eastern, usually when I'm done for the day. I won't take any more trades after 9 o'clock. The vertical lines, two others, this is the stock market open at 6:30 Pacific, 9:30 Eastern. And this is when there's often news at 7 o'clock Pacific or 10 o'clock Eastern. Yes, Tony, it's recorded. Now, and then the gray highlights are blackout periods because I don't like to enter when the market just opens or when the stock market's opening or during news events. You get some wild price fluctuations that can cause you some grief. The vertical lines, this is the opening price, yesterday's close. The purple line is yesterday's close. Down here is yesterday's point of control. But I'm going to invite you to a tutorial at the end here so we can talk about it then. Now, and ask yourself questions. The market, as you come in, has been selling off. You see a support level set right there. Now ask yourself, who's selling right here? Now, do you think it's a professional trader selling right there? I don't. Look at this here. This should look exactly like that graphic I just showed you. The support level is set here. The market advances, then it pulls back. Who is selling right here? Do you think it's professional traders? By definition, a professional trader buys. They won't be professional very long if they don't do that. This is just last Wednesday. What? Look it up here. Who's buying? Buying right there between $780 and $7783. Professional traders. It's newcomers, retail traders chasing the breakout. Same token. Now, something interesting happens over here as well. All right, here you set a level, and then you fail to breach it. And that failure, this is a great short opportunity. I actually shorted the market here. I shorted here and here. I missed the long that day. This is the high of the day, if you watch what happens next. Okay, now, I've only got 3 minutes, so I want to do, I need to invite you to a tutorial that describes how we do the things that we're talking about here, okay? There's a Keltner channel on the chart here. It's 30-period moving average with a 1.5 ATR. First, let's get the invitation out to the tutorial. It's 3 hours long. It's free. There's no cost. The idea is I want to help you understand technically how you take the concepts we talked about today and implement them in practice. Okay, I normally do this on Saturday, but with Thanksgiving, we're going to have to do it after the Thanksgiving week. So I'm going to send, if I can get Reed to send that out, that'll work. But I'm going to send it out in reply to one of these questions, and then I'm going to show you something else as long as we have time. Let's see here. So if you guys can verify for me that you can see that. That's a link to register for a free trading program tutorial. It's 3 hours long. It will be recorded. And we talk about exactly the technical methods that we use to identify where are the unskilled traders trading. Okay? Where are they trading? You want to find the unskilled trader if you can. The alternative is figure out what the big boys are doing and then get in a way that allows you to do it without requiring a really big account. I'm going to turn on two things, and then I just think Reed to step in and stop me when I'm out of time here. This one and this one and this one. It'll take a second for it to calculate everything out because I've got 4 months of data in here. Give it just a moment. What you're going to see here is some signals that help you understand what people are doing, okay? That's an amazing short signal, long signal, another short here. The stars represent volume. You're seeing lots and lots of volume. And so when I see that in a thin market like oil, that often means exhaustion. You're not seeing the registration link. Okay, let me try to send it again. If we can get Reed to send it as well.
Yeah, I did pop it out to the entire audience. I put it out there twice. Okay, so I see Chris.
There
Nathan.
It is.
Okay, they do. Okay, cool.
Oops, let me move that. That's in the wrong way now. Okay. And now, Reed, am I out of time?
You're looking at about 2 more minutes.
All right. So what you're looking at here is the best thing to do at this point is just come to the tutorial, okay? Because this is a completely different way of looking at the market than you're used to. This is the chart I use every day. All right. You'll notice there's no oscillators or stochastics. There's only one moving average on here. It's the Keltner channel. Everything else is aimed at understanding what are the market participants doing. This green diamond, it means I'm seeing a lot of selling at the bid, but the price is closing up. I should not be closing up. Price should be going down if I'm seeing lots of selling. If it's closing up, it means there's a lot of buying absorbing all that selling. This is called the absorption long signal. It's the same thing up here. I'm seeing lots of buying at the ask. People are stepping up to pay more, but price is closing down. Price should not be going down if people are buying at the ask. It should be going up. When you see it going down, you're looking at absorption. You're looking at exhaustion. Here, it's screaming at you. You're just nicking the high and closing down. This is a very, very, for me, a very obvious short right there. This one here, a very clean long, right? Entry's right there. On volume, a lot of buying, a lot of excitement, a lot of fear, a lot of panic. But the market stalls, it's not going up. And you see it all get absorbed right there. Same thing down here. Panic selling, break support. But it all gets absorbed and the market bounces up. In this case, what I love about the oil market is you can go long or short and make nice money in this market. All of these are, you know, this is a 50 tick run top to bottom from entry to exit here. This turned right at the previous day's VPOC also. Very, very key thing. This turn, previous high a day. That's the white line. Okay. I have a signal not shown that says right there, you're reversing, pay attention. And again, right there. So come to the tutorial. Because of the Thanksgiving holiday, it's a little bit further out. You know, I don't want to get into holiday weekend. So we'll do it Tuesday, the 12th. Okay. If you're not seeing the link, it's very easy to find on the site, or you can just send me an email, info@therationaltrader.com. On the site itself, if I can find my browser, it's very easy to just go to the Rational Trader, and if you just scroll down, look at current webinars, go to, it's December 2nd, next Tuesday, okay? 3 hours, there's no cost. I don't want you to think you're not gonna get charged. All right. The cost for my service is very, very inexpensive. It's $5 a month. What I'm trying to do is make it easy for you to try, easy to remove the barriers to entry. All these indicators that are custom, if you're a member, you don't have to pay for them. Mostly I want to get the message out that you got to focus on your biology if you want to be successful, and here's the way to do it. Okay.